Welcome. I'm Patricia Sargent, and this is Industry Insiders, the show in which we chat with people who work primarily behind the scenes to support and promote the importance of literature. On this episode, we're getting the scoop from David Weaver, Executive Director of the Ohioana Library, which is based in Columbus, Ohio. David, thank you so very much for joining us today. It's always so lovely to see you.
It's good to see you, Patricia. Thank you for inviting me to do this. It's going to be fun.
Oh, it absolutely will, and it's my pleasure. Before we take a deep dive into the Ohioana Library, I'm going to ask you a question that people are often asking me. What does Ohioana mean?
Yes, we get that all the time. The first time I called somebody after I was new at Ohioana and I introduced myself, I said, I'm from the Ohioana Library. And there was a pause and they said, Ohioana? And so a lot of people are confused by it. But the suffix ana, the Latin suffix ana, added to any word means pertaining to. Like Americana, people are most familiar with the term Americana, pertaining to America, where Ohioana simply means pertaining to Ohio, the state of Ohio. And in our particular case, it means pertaining to Ohio literature and other creative endeavors, and particularly for us, pertaining to books by Ohio authors or about Ohio subjects.
Wonderful, wonderful. The Ohioana Library Association was founded by then Ohio First Lady Martha Kinney Cooper in 1929, which, by the way, means your centennial is around the corner.
Yes.
Why did she think it was important to establish the association?
When Mrs. Cooper moved into the governor's residence in 1929 with her husband, Governor Myers White Cooper, she was an avid reader. And so one of the first things that she was interested in was the library that was in the governor's residence. And she felt with all of the people that would come there for social events and for meetings, et cetera, she said, if there's one place that should have a collection of books by Ohio authors or about Ohio subjects, it should be here. And so from that simple idea, a collection of books by Ohio authors or about Ohio subjects, she started the Ohioana Library in October of 1929. So you're indeed right. We're right at the time of celebrating our 90th birthday. So another 10 years will be our centennial. So, but it always started from a very simple concept that she had, and it was thankful that she was an avid reader and that she believed that Ohio's writers and artists and musicians should have promotion and have recognition and should have a collection where their works were preserved.
Oh, beautiful. What, in your opinion, makes Ohioana, the Ohioana Library, so special?
Well, I do think the fact that we are, as far as we can tell, Patricia, we are the only library in the country that has as its specific purpose the literature and creative works by people from that state. You would think that there would be Ohioanas all over the country. And every state does have a Center for the Book. A Center for the Book is a program of the Library of Congress. And so Ohio's is located at the Cleveland Public Library. So they're generally headquartered somewhere else. But again, they have a much broader thing, whereas Ohioana, we are totally and strictly about Ohio literature. Interestingly enough, somebody asked me last year or said last year, so you're just about Ohio authors and books? Isn't that sort of parochial? And I said, you mean like cheering for the Buckeyes? I said, if a state can be proud of its football and baseball and basketball players, why not be proud of its poets, its novelists, its illustrators? Because when you think about it, and one of the things that, you know, I love about being here is that people are amazed when they find out the incredible authors who have come from Ohio or called this home or are living here right now. And as I was saying, you know, yes, LeBron James is fantastic, you know, basketball player. But you know what? The wonderful and beloved Toni Morrison, who passed away this summer, she won the Nobel Prize in Literature. That's not too shabby. I mean, isn't that something to be proud of?
It's extraordinary. And I'm so glad that you made the comparison between intellect and physicality.
Yes.
Together, they're awesome. But we need to respect those intellectual achievements too.
Yes.
Well, I'm so glad that you had that comeback, because it's really important. I also was wondering, why is the Ohioana Library important to Ohio, and why is it important to the country? Because I think it's important to both the state and the country. Why do you think?
Well, and this is a question, you know, that comes up, you know, whenever we're meeting with funders, et cetera, you know, well, you know, what is Ohioana's particular thing that it does versus, say, Thurber House or some other place like that? And as well, because we're about all of the literature of the entire state, whereas Thurber House, which we partner with on a number of projects, so wonderful they are, but again, they're devoted primarily to a single author and to a single genre of writing, humor. Whereas we're encompassing every form of literature. It's like, you know, about the Ohioana Book Festival, what I like to say. We're about something for every reader of every age. And the other important thing is not just about, you know, the scope of us being, you know, all genres and all types of writing and for readers of all ages. But the fact that we look at one of our roles as promoting Ohio as one of America's great literary centers. And Jerome Lawrence and Robert E. Lee, the playwrights who wrote Inherit the Wind and Anti-Mame and the musical Mame that it was based on, when they received an award from Ohioana for their career achievements, Jerry Lawrence said he was so proud that they were in Ohioana, because he said Ohioana is the literary Fort Knox of Ohio. You're the collector and keeper of the gold of poetry and fiction and nonfiction and children's literature. So and I use that that comment quite often and stuff. So therefore, like I said, you know, we have, and as you know, we have a number of programs, but the Ohioana Awards, which are coming up, where we recognize outstanding achievement by authors of books every year. But we also have another award that we give at the same time called the Walter Rumsey Marvin Grant. Walter Rumsey Marvin was the second director of Ohioana. And when he passed away, his family created an endowment and to fund a special prize for an Ohio writer age 30 or younger who has not yet published a book.
Wow.
So that to encourage a young writer. And over the years, it's helped jumpstart a number of young authors, including in the year 2000, when he was 26 years old, the winner was Anthony Doerr. And 15 years later, Tony won the Pulitzer Prize in fiction. So So we're very proud of it. I mean, that was a feather in our cap. That we kind of, you know, I asked Tony one time, I said, Tony, is a prize like this, you know, like the Marvin Grant important? He said, you know, when you're a young writer trying to break in to the business, and he said, there are so many of us competing. He said, to win a prize like the Ohioana Marvin Grant, he said, it's like somebody who's legitimate points a finger at you and says, keep your eye on this person, they're good. And he said, you know, within a year of winning that grant, he got a contract for his first agent and his first book. So he said it really did help to jumpstart his career. And, you know, that's something we're very proud of. So that's one of the things that we feel, you know, talking about how are we important to the nation. You know, we've helped launch some people who have gone on to substantial careers. You know, I mentioned Toni Morrison. And of course, Tony won the Nobel Prize in Literature, won the Pulitzer Prize and the National Book Circle Critics Award. The very first prize she ever won was the Ohioana Book Award for Sula in 1975.
Wow.